Hey witches, Tiffany here of Bewitching Bemused. Today I want to show all of you what my daily spiritual practice looks like as of 2021. Before we begin, I do have a surprise announcement that I will kind of hint at throughout this video, but of course I'm gonna make a full announcement at the end of this video, so please make sure to stick around for that. This is just my daily practice, things that I do, well, daily, I think that's a given, but on just your average day. So this does not factor in different things that I would switch up or do differently or add in if it were something like an Espit or a Sabbat, or I had a major cleansing planned, or divination reading, or a big, big spell planned. This also doesn't really cover the things that I do on like a weekly or a monthly basis, such as like checking in with jars that I have, you know, ongoing, that I shake them up, I add things, I take things out, I recharge things, or items around my house that I recharge, or I reset certain, you know, wards and protective items. So we're not gonna go into that. Like I said, this is just my average day. Let's get started. Let's start in the morning. I love early mornings. I am an early riser, usually at about 5 a.m. At that time, it's still dark out. The world is quiet. You know, my fiance is still asleep. I kind of get this little peaceful time to myself. I feel like the world isn't even awake with me yet. It's just me. And it's still darkness. I get to still enjoy that aspect of the night, but it's also fresh. It's a fresh day. So I love to do a lot of my routine work at that time. When I get up, I get some mundane things out of the way. I feed the pets and I make my coffee. Every morning, no matter what the weather is, I always set my coffee on the windowsill to let it cool for a while. This is also to allow it to be infused with the morning air. And I also love the idea that you have the water that made the coffee, you have the coffee grounds, a plant from the earth, you have the heat to brew the coffee that represents fire, and then now I'm adding some air into the mix. So I start off every morning with a good healthy dose of the four elements and caffeine, because that's always a good thing. I will get back to the coffee once it's cooled in just a moment, but part of what I love about this is that, you know, like I had mentioned, this is a fresh start. It's a fresh day. And the air in the morning, at least where I live, I know this isn't how it is everywhere, but the air is always fresh, it's cool. Any time throughout the year, morning air at 5 a.m. has a coolness to it. It just feels lovely to inhale. So I like the idea that that is being infused into my coffee. That I'm going to carry with me for the rest of the day. One thing I sort of skipped over was that when I first wake up, if my dream is very fleeting, whatever I dreamt about, if I can feel it is slipping away from me, I will quickly jot down what the little shreds are that I do remember. Those shreds are usually enough for me to come back to later and elaborate on. It's enough to get that the memory of that dream ingrained in my waking mind, my awoken mind, and now I can elaborate on it based off of those little bullet points. So that's what I do when my coffee is cooling, is I journal my dreams. For the longest time, I could not remember them until I started jotting down those little bullet points. And over time, that ability to recall my dreams got stronger and stronger. So before bed, sometimes I will ask for a sign or some guidance from Hecate or my ancestors in a dream. Or I'll just repeat in my mind over and over something that I know that I emotionally need to process. I'll focus on an internal problem that I need my subconscious to help me unravel, because that is the main purpose of dreaming, right? Is for your subconscious to deal with things, to process things, and to communicate with you and give you signs. It's trying to help you, right? So I know I'm jumping ahead into the evening, like right before I go to sleep, but that is something that I will do sometimes that will affect my dreams, is I will ask for guidance or a sign, or I will repeat something in my head. So my mind is focused on this one thing that I need my brain to help me break it down. And so I can, you know, do that while I sleep, because I'm a multitasker. So those are things that I make sure to always consistently keep a record of. After that, I do an energy scan. So the purpose of this is to see if anything's off. I literally scan my energy. I send my awareness into the top of my head and I send it all the way down to my fingertips, down, all the way to my tippy toes. And then I send it right back up. It's not so much moving the energy around as it is scanning it. Like I said, I'm just sending my awareness through the energy as opposed to moving the energy from like one place to another. But I do find that this is a great way for me to find if something kind of feels off in my body. It's also a great way to start moving the energy because, well, I'm not moving the energy, but I am moving through it. It's sort of waking it up. And then I'll also find if there are spots, like I've talked before about I have a bad knee, and sometimes I feel like those spots in particular, I will pay attention to during the scan and find like, do I need to work on that area? And I will just sort of energetically massage this area. That's actually a technique that I learned from New Energy Ways, which I did review if you guys are interested in checking that out. It's a completely free PDF. But I find that when I do that energy scan, it sort of wakes up the energy. It's sort of, like I said, it passes through it. So it's gonna send ripples out. Like I'm not intentionally moving the energy, but I can kind of feel it undulating. So it's a nice, easy way to wake it up as opposed to just being like, all right, now we're gonna work out. After that, I meditate. I do several minutes of silent routine meditation, and then I'll spend a few minutes focusing on either my new moon or my full moon intention. So if the moon is waning, I focus on my full moon intention. And if the moon is waxing, I focus on my new moon intention. Then I do a divination reading. Usually for my daily morning divination readings, I consult my runes. But every once in a while, if I feel like my bones collection or a tarot deck is calling to me, I'll use that instead. But it's rarely my tarot deck because it hates me. On average, I ask about 3 questions, but this is not for any reason. Like sometimes I'll just ask 2 and sometimes I'll ask 5. It varies day by day, but on average it's 3. If I have something planned for that day that I want to know something about, I will ask it about that. But a lot of the time I'll let my intuition guide me to my questions. Sometimes it's, what do I need to avoid today? What should I prioritize? Is there anything, you know, my ancestors need me to know today, etc. Or sometimes a question will be a follow-up question to the previous question. This is another area of my craft that I started seeing huge improvement in once I started journaling it daily. Admittedly, I used to forget what questions I asked and what the answers were. So it was sort of like, okay, well, what's the point of having done that if I'm not going to hold that information, that guidance with me throughout the rest of the day? It also took me longer to realize that my tarot deck did not like me. I wasn't recording everything, so I wasn't keeping track so I could go back and be like, wow, every time I use this tarot deck, it makes no sense, or it's the complete opposite. I'm either really bad at this or this deck is screwing with me. And over a long period of time, I learned that that tarot deck in particular was screwing with me. It just didn't like me. You guys probably already know this about me, but I always encourage you, keep journals of things, because although this is magic and it's spiritual, there is a certain scientific process to it. If you track long-term patterns, there are so many ways that you can expand your craft and your whole practice system if you learn what works for you and what doesn't, whether that's in spell work, whether that's in divination. So just, I won't go on about it, but keep journals of everything. Usually by that point, my coffee is cool enough to drink, and I always add cinnamon. This is for luck, spiritual protection, and because it helps magnify intentions. And of course, it tastes really good. As I stir in the cinnamon, I also stir in an intention for the day. Now, this is often based around what I learned from my morning divination, but sometimes if I have something planned for the day, and that takes precedence over everything else, I'll stir in an intention specifically for that. After that, I chill out a little bit and I drink my coffee. I do some mundane things like I will log all my food for the day in my Fitness Pal. I'll check my email, you know, things like that. Completely mundane and non-magical, so I'm just gonna skip over it. But after that point, when I've finished my coffee, I do my workout for the day. Now, I work out with magic. I do incorporate magic into my weightlifting and my cardio and pretty much every aspect of my fitness, but that is a topic for a whole other video, which I promise I will do at some point, but I'm gonna skip ahead because it would just take way too long. And showering for the day after that is pretty mundane. If I need a good cleanse, I will typically hold off until the evening, and I will do that. If I need a spiritual cleanse, I will do that in a ritual bath. I mean, occasionally I might use like a magical body scrub in the shower, but it's not like a daily thing. Usually my showers are just like, I need to be clean. I also won't go into my whole skincare and makeup routine because that's really long and boring, but I have typically either rose oil, full moon water, and or a rose quartz in several of my products. Then I choose my jewelry for the day. If I know I need something specific, I will wear that. Otherwise, I might just kind of pick out what I like or the things that I regularly wear or what happens to match my outfit. Same goes for my crystals that I will usually keep in either a pocket or my bra if I don't have pockets that day. If I need something specific, I grab it. Otherwise, I hover my hand over it over all my crystals to ask which one I'm going to need for the day until one calls out to me. Then, I mean, that's it for the morning. Usually there's at least like one random act of magic during the day. But then we get to the end of the day and I brew either a cup of decaf tea or decaf coffee because sometimes I just crave the flavor of coffee. If I feel I need a particular herb or spice based on herbalism components or magical correspondences, I use that. Otherwise, I go with whatever sounds tasty. If I have any spells planned, I typically do them at this point or I continue an ongoing spell. In addition, if I need some extra meditation time, whether it's just to de-stress or because I want to get a lengthier session in or commune with spirit or deity, I do so. But that's not necessarily a regular thing, but I typically do that a few times a week. Same thing with more in-depth divination. If I need it, it usually happens in the evenings. Then several times a week, I place out offerings to Hecate and or my ancestors, especially if I happen to find something that day that I thought they might like. And at this time, I wash my face, which I sort of view as a cleansing. I'm removing everything, all the energies I got blasted with during the day. I kind of view my face washing as that, and then I practice my evening skincare routine, which again, I'm not gonna bore you with the details. But not only is there the cleansing, the washing away of everything I came into contact with that day, but there's also sort of, you know, in the process of massaging myself, I feel like I'm working out the stress of the day, if it was a stressful day. At that point, I sort of nestle in. I'll sit down either at my desk or in bed, and I will journal about my day. I will also come back to my divination journal to look over my reading from that morning once again, and I write down, you know, what was accurate, what was inaccurate, what did I misinterpret, what actually happened, that sort of thing. And I also study. That's usually the point at which I will get a little bit of, if I'm whatever book I'm in the middle of reading, I will read a few chapters from it. Then that's about it. Usually my fiance and I will kind of, we'll cook dinner together, catch up on our days, we'll hang out for a little bit, we might watch some TV or whatever. But typically when we're watching TV, once I'm done eating, I get a little bit of stretching in. Now, stretching is a great way to, it's just good for you. It's really good for you. Everybody should stretch. but it's also a good way to shake up energy. If you've had a negative or an active day and you need to unwind, stretching is a great way to do that. It's sort of like what I mentioned in the morning about easing that energy awake through your body by doing the body scan. And when you do that energy scan, it sort of just sends out little ripples. It's not a jarring experience. This is sort of the reverse. You're stretching to still shake up the energy, you know, roll any knots out, get rid of any negativity or static areas, especially whether you're very active during the day or whether you sit a lot during the day or stand a lot but not really moving. Stretching is really good to just shake things up and get things moving, get things cleared out. That said, I highly encourage everyone to set up a daily routine for themselves. Now, it doesn't have to be this elaborate, or it could be more elaborate, or it can just be simple. Like I said, I wake up at 5 a.m. every day, and that gives me a lot of time to do all these things. And not everybody is able to do that. Or if you have kids, or if you have work and school, you may just not be able to fit all of it into your day. But even if it's just one thing that you do repeatedly every day, it can make such a huge impact on your life and on your spiritual practice to keep it going. And when you have a spiritual thing you do every day, you are going to feel much more in tune with your spirituality in general, moment to moment, even when you're not actively doing something magical or spiritual. And I find it so easy to incorporate magic into the mundane things I already do. Like, look at my coffee in the morning. That one is always recommended by people because it's so easy to incorporate. Lots of us drink caffeine in the morning, whether that's coffee or tea. Most of us have a morning drink that we have. You're gonna have it daily anyway, so you may as well incorporate some magic into it and make it part of your spiritual practice. That way you have at least that one thing, bare minimum, you have that one thing you do every single day. So that said, here is my announcement. You probably figured it out because I was harping on the journals. I do think it's very important to keep journals, which is why I designed two more for you guys. Now, these are going to go into my witchcraft journal set that is sold on Amazon. In addition to that, if you prefer loose leaf, if you don't like buying the bound books, you like to three-hole punch and organize them however you want, I do also sell the printable versions on my Etsy account. Everything is linked down below in the description box. So the first book I'm very excited to announce is the Daily Divination Journal. This one provides you 365 pages for you to do daily divination readings for a year. It has space for you to track things like which method and which set did you use, which layout did you use, did you call upon deity, ancestors, spirits, fae, etc. for guidance, what were your questions, what were your answers, what were your interpretations of those answers, and so on. And like I mentioned earlier, it's really important to track your accuracy, what you got correct, what you misinterpreted, why you misinterpreted it, and how things actually played out. The other one is a dream journal. Now, I already went on about the importance of tracking your dreams. Now, most importantly, a huge section of this book is dedicated to describing the entirety of your dream, but I also created sections for listing out who was in your dream. Were there any significant objects in it? What was the setting? There are sections for you to draw out a mind map as well as any symbols that appeared to you. Your interpretation of what that dream meant. And there's a section for you to come back to and fill it out later if your dream ended up being prophetic. This one has enough pages for you to fill out for 6 months, assuming that you dream and remember your dreams every night for 6 months. So most likely it'll last you longer than that. But these are just a continuation of that series. Of course, the first one that I published was the Magic Journal for you to track all of your spells so so you can get the most out of your spell results and continuously improve upon your spell work. All of which, like I said, are on Amazon in paperback format, or of course you can purchase the printables off my Etsy shop. If you're subscribed to my Patreon, everyone in the top two tiers gets a continuously updated 25% discount code to my Etsy shop. So I really hope you guys love those. I put a lot of time and work into them. I really base them off of things that I found it useful to track based on my own practice and from getting some feedback from other people that I've spoken to. So I really hope you guys love them. I hope they help you really expand your craft and get more in touch with yourself and your own personal brand of practice. Anyway, that's it for today. I would love to hear about your guys' daily practices as well. Drop those down in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you didn't like this video, you're probably already giving it a thumbs down. That's fine. And if you are brand new, welcome. I hope you stick around and subscribe. Anyway, everyone, that's it for now. I love you all so much, and I'm just excited to share my daily practice with you. I don't know why. It's a very personal part of me, and it's just been fun to share it. So that's it. I'll see you all on next Wednesday. I'm a mess. Anyway, I'll see you all next Wednesday. In the meantime, stay magical.